Right, in this video I'm planning to swap the engine on this CBR125, taking this tuned one out, and I've got one over here that's stock. So I'm going to swap those. My friend Keith Bolton, when we did the 24 hours, we had an engine blow up, and within 45 minutes of the engine blowing up, we were back on the track. It was that quick. I was actually asleep at the time. Then someone came and woke me up. Quickly, you need to get on the bike. And I went out and the engine had blown up, changed it, 45 minutes. I don't think I'm going to be able to do that, and I'm going to be faffing about filming it, but should be able to do this in about an hour. So I'm going to attempt to film it as best I can. I don't know whether to just leave the camera there, or I might move it around with me. Anyway, first thing I've got to do is drain the water out of it. Actually, I've already drained the water out of it weeks ago. Didn't strictly need to take the seat off. Easy enough to do. 12 mil to the tank bolt. Let's get me a magnet. Put this in. Disconnect the vacuum hose and the fuel line. There's no fuel level sender on this tank. Disconnect the water hoses. Doing this, I try and do everything on one side and then go around and do everything on the other side, so you end up forgetting what you've taken off and what you haven't. So next, alright, so water hoses off. One from the top of the radiator to the back of the cylinder head. Forgotten about that one before. Starter motor. Oh, need a 5 mil. 5 mil Allen head for that, and 10 mil spanner. With a positive connection for the starter motor, you have to be careful not to spin the bolt round because you break the starter motor. So make sure you hold the tab while you undo it. Just make sure the cables are clear in the engine so they're not in the way when you drop it out. What else we've got around here? Clutch cable. Half an hour to change the engine, half an hour to find the tools. Clutch cable off. Let's do the exhaust next. I think they are, not 13. There is a mounting point under here, but most people don't bother using it for racing, so the exhaust will just drop down. I might pull it out of the way, take it off so I can drop the engine easier. That's HT lead. Tape under the bottom of the radiator to move it forward out of the way. That should be a 10mm. Catching on the fairing there. Right, it's carburettor. Oh, let's just do everything on this side. I can slacken the engine mounting bolts. So 12mm for these. And the front mounting engine bolts 14mm. Usually have one on each side. This is where it's useful to have a friend doing it with you. Okay, that's loose.
and then one at the top on the back. Okay, so I've got everything loose on this side. We'll go to the top, do the fuel and carbs, and then we'll go to the left hand side.
Throttle slide. I'm going to be removing this because in the Freetech series next year everyone needs to run an airbox. So I've got an airbox and I don't think I can do both, but we'll do, have a look at that later. Drain hoses. And I've got an inlet rubber on the other one, so I will leave this one on and just remove the carburettor. This is a lot quicker than doing the SV650 one. Carburettor. I do have a programmable CDI on this one for the tuned engine, but with when I move to stock, I'll leave this on, but I'll be using that as the stock one there. So that's all free now. So that will go to the to there, and then these are the wires that go to the engine for the pickup coil and the generator, and this is the neutral light switch. Not entirely necessary, but I like to have a neutral light. So that's everything from the top of the engine. No pair valve system in this, it's just blocked off. I've got some silicon in there. I'll move to this side. So I've got to, we should disconnect the battery for safety. I forgot to mention that. Go on, let's do it. Mil for the sprocket cover. 7 mil. Allen keys in here. They're usually 10 mil bolts, aren't they? I've got a 15 tooth sprocket in the box. Next time I ride it, I'm going to be that lid. I think I'll probably need a smaller one for there. I'll swap that over. Gear lever. I got 10 mil on there.
You didn't see me do that. I'll take these two. Go around the other side and take up the rest of the engine supports. Still rolling. We are. Hard bit's getting the other one in. Notice I put the bolts from the other way. It's because I haven't taken this cover off and I couldn't get to it. It doesn't really matter. I Okay, that's all the engine bolts in. I'll do the exhaust next, and then I'll do the items on each side. Tight. Hasn't got a sprocket on, I'll have to go hunting for one in a bit. I'll do everything else. Let's do the radiator. Radiator holes I've just put on there. I'm going to be using a stock CDI, so this is the wire for that. Neutral light. Take this off. Shame, I really like my little red trumpet. I'm expecting I'll need to put different jets in, a smaller main jet, but for now I'll just connect it up. Thank you. get the starter wires on. I left my tools around there again. Lead. The negative, the off lead. And the positive. Clutch. Connect the battery. I think it's got oil in because it has a wired sump plug, but I'm not taking any chances because I've done this before and I've destroyed an engine. Not very much oil. No oil. Hardly any oil. Good thing I checked. Motul, fully synthetic, good stuff. They only hold a litre. I'm not sure whether this is low because it had run a long time and burnt it off or what. Let's put some in. If you want to know how long an engine like this will run without oil in it, probably longer than you think. We managed to run one for an hour and a half in a race before it blew itself up. Cam seized. Yep, that's taken about 750, but it's not at the top. Let's give it a little top up. Right to the top line there. Yeah, lock wire, some plug, lock wire on there as per race requirements. I've got some distilled water from my dehumidifier. They only hold about a litre usually. Okay, it's turning over. Trying to get any air bubbles out of the cooling system. That runs on brake cleaner. Just need to put the tank on and everything. I'm going to leave it at that because I want to faff around with the air box. Thanks for watching. Make a shout out.